Hey, it's Jared Bishop here, and today I'm going to show you some little level editor key bindings, because that was requested in the comments, so I guess I might as well do it right now. So, and just one little thing to note, these are all the default key bindings, so you may have changed them, and they might not be the same here. So let's get started with movement. So once you're in the normal editor, you can see moving the mouse around just doesn't really do anything, but you can hold right click to move. You gotta hold right click. And you can do WASD for forwards, backwards, left, etc. You can move the mouse to look in different directions. You can hold shift to move faster. Hold control to move a bit slower. And when you're holding right click, you can use Q and E to move up and down. And another cool little thing, you can use the mouse scroll wheel to move super fast, like scroll up or scroll down, while you're holding left click. And I think it's really useful. Nice for like going across a map. Especially my moon map, since it's so huge. It's like shameless advertising. Other stuff you can do, just these are just generic stuff. Control Z to undo something. You can do Control S to save the map. I don't really use that. You can just click save. That's what I usually do. And now to terrain editing, you can you see I have this little thing here. You can click Q to toggle the raising and lowering of the terrain. You can do W to smooth it out and E to flatten it. And now moving on to roads, you can click to create a road node and they will link up as you can see, and you can press bake to create the road. And now you can click on separate nodes and press E to move them about, including the little tabs off the side of the node, and you can just click delete to remove a node. So now for navigation, you can click to add a marker, you can press E to move it, or delete to delete the whole thing, obviously. And same with nodes, you can press E to move it, delete it, to remove it, etc. And now, this is for the rest of everything, like the spawn tabs, resources, player spawns, and everything. They're all pretty much the same. It's E to add whatever it is, Q to delete it, and it'll like create a little sphere, I guess, and it'll delete everything in the sphere. And that's used on all those places. And now on to objects, the fun stuff. So you can click on an object here in the little selection here, and press E to place it down in the world. And once in the world, you can move it around like this. Press E to move it to where the cursor is. You can move it around like this. It's fun stuff. You can deselect it by either clicking on it again or clicking elsewhere, just like in the sky or on the ground or whatever. And you can do Control-C to copy the object, and Control V to paste it again, and delete to delete it. And now for the like moving around, you can do Q to put it in translation mode, just like move it up, down, left, right, whatever. W puts it in rotation mode, so you can rotate it left, right, up, down, up, you can't rotate it up, down, you know what I mean. And finally, R puts it into sort of scale mode, I think that's what it's called, and you can drag the little points off of it to make it bigger or smaller in that direction, or you can just drag the white one in the middle and make the whole thing bigger. And one also little neat thing that not a lot of people realize is you can do Control B while selecting an object to save that position. And like if you get another object, let's say this one right here, you can just do Control N to put it in the position that the first object was in. So it's really nice. I use it a lot. I guess I could give you an example, but that's too much work. So thanks for watching.